welcome to Talking Crass. Pete, we're back. We've just seen Justice League,
everyone.
We've just seen Justice League. And we're eager to talk about it.
We're fresh as it comes, Hal.
I mean, it's 4 p.m, Bede. We're hot to trot.
If we were two little baguettes, right?
I'm sober.
Aye.
I'm drinking coffee, not vodka and orange.
If we were two baguettes out of a supermarket franchise, which we can't name due to not being licensed to, we would be piped, like, you know when you press against the papery layer, which they keep it in, it would be steamy hot.
What are you talking about?
How fresh, I'm using the analogue.
When have you ever gone to a supermarket and bought a baguette that's hot and fresh?
I've done that before.
I've never been to a supermarket and bought a baguette.
I'm using that. What the fucking called again? It starts right here.
A panini.
No, man. When you use imagery to describe something you feel. Oh. An analog. Allegory.
No, allegory is reading between the lines.
Oh.
Analogy.
Analogy. Hello. Okay.
Oh, my God.
The
sorry.
Piping hot, warm, fresh, doughy bread is our
feelings.
Yeah, know how fresh we're off the press.
Is it because we're all fluffy inside?
Bingo.
We're hot off the press. We've just got out of the cinema. We apologise. We were originally going to do Jaws, but we saw this film and we needed to roll the microphones out.
It dropped our Jaws. That works on really three levels.
That's an awful.
We dropped Jaws. We dropped our draw.
What are you talking about? Right. Anyway, people, it's going to follow the usual structure with a little bit of Walking Dead talking.
Oh, God. It's not the usual structure.
I know we threw Walking Dead in there. I'm going to start off with Walking Dead. Then we're going to go on to Not Necessary Top 5. Then a bit True or False Trivia. Then we're going to discuss the film Justice League.
I haven't wrote down any notes, so this is just out the dome.
Beat's going to spitball on this episode.
Spitballing.
It's a mastermind of wealth. And knowledge.
And bread.
And love of CGI.
Of course.
Are you up to date on the Walking Dead, please?
Episode 1?
You've watched episode 1.
Where are we up to now?
This is episode 3.
Oh,
although
fuck.
There's 4 episodes.
What?
We're one behind, I think.
You're one behind. We're all...
So spoilers for Walking Dead episode 3.
Spoiler for us, John, what happened?
Right. First point. I mean, I enjoy the zombies' practical makeup, but rolling down the hill was ridiculous.
Well, I don't know what that means, right. I haven't seen the episode.
So, they've caught all the saviours, and they've got them in...
Who were the saviours again?
Negan's lot.
They caught them all.
They've caught them, and they've got them in chains.
Every single one?
They haven't killed them.
Every single one?
No, just a group.
Poindexter Bullet Man?
Just a group. They've just caught the group. They're walking towards... The hilltop?
Where's that again? They're all so bland, I can't remember where they're at.
I don't know where the location's been.
Oh, hilltop had the guy who, from GTA, was blackmailing Weak
yes,
Sauce Man.
Yes,
Weak Sauce
yes,
Cliche
yeah, yeah.
Boy.
Oh, I nearly lost me right there.
Right.
So what happened was, they came to like a bit of a valley, and they're walking down it.
Let's guess, did they get ambushed?
Well...
Valley means ambush.
One of them's winding Morgan up to try and kill them, really.
Right.
They're having a laugh about it. You're not going to kill us. Next minute you know, you turn around, there's zombies rolling down the hill.
Oh,
like
my
a load,
God.
You know, when
God.
A, you know, a kid when you used to play roly poly?
Yes, yes.
So out of nowhere, I mean, they could have ran and got
away. Is this one of them shit producer, right? Executive producer
they
ideas?
Ran, they could have got away with it, but anyway, these zombies come down.
Right.
Next scene, on them,
yeah.
Eating them all.
Terrible.
Anyway, there's a few survive. I've got my next point, sorry. I thought Jesus knew the score. So apparently he doesn't want to kill anyone.
What?
But, like, they all made this pact to kill everyone. Because they need to take over by force.
Okay.
It ends in Jesus and Morgan fighting for 5 minutes.
In the zombies?
No, there's no zombies there. It's just them in some woods fighting for 5 minutes.
This sounds awful.
Next point. Maggie has now changed for the better. So after watching Glenn get his face stoved in with a baseball bat,
right.
She's now forgotten it all, and she's a good person. She doesn't want to kill any saviors.
Of course.
Okay. Next point. Death of a character who had 5 minutes of screen time.
Ugh.
So I'm not going to spoil who it was for you, but right. I wasn't bothered in the slightest.
Okay.
Next point. Ending, not that bad. You'll know what I mean if you've watched it. again, I said spoilers, but I think we can go through this without spoiling it.
Okay.
Got us hooked a little bit to watch the next episode.
I don't have a clue. Can I guess?
Yes.
Negan kills Dwight.
Wrong. and then my last point's just it wasn't a bad episode.
Okay.
That's the Walking Dead discussion, babe. For another week.
Rolling Dead.
Are you going to watch it or not?
No.
Have you totally eradicated it?
I'm dead.
Game over.
The time's now too precious.
It's dead, yeah.
Precious.
Right, babe. Let's roll on not necessarily top five, beat.
Nice segue. Please.
Not necessarily top five. Franchises that won't or wouldn't die. Maybe. You're getting the gist of the podcast episode already.
Uh-oh. Burying the hatchet.
I'm very worried about this.
Why are you worried about it?
I don't know. I'm worried.
Okay, John's worried because
we've seen a lot of other reviews.
Justice League.
Got fucking coffee on me. We can't just laugh all the way through it. We've got to be semi-serious, you know.
And semi-serious. Semi. Classic.
We'll go into not necessarily top five, babe.
Right.
Do you want me not necessarily top five, haven't we?
What is the not necessarily top five, John?
Not necessarily top five franchises that won't or wouldn't die.
Very good.
That kind of gives you an inkling into the episode.
That it does.
Anyways, and we've covered why I feel a bit awkward about it, but...
Yes.
We'll move on. Beat will hit you on straight away. Saw.
Oh, that's a great shout.
Saw films. What they're up to now? Six.
Eight.
Jesus Christ. How can you think of that many ways to kill someone? Interestingly.
What they did? They can't. That's the fucking point. They ran out of the two.
Including Saw. Final Destination. Halloween.
Jesus.
Any horror film really franchise?
Calm down.
Okay, sorry.
So mine's scary movie. No.
Beat gives one way that you can kill someone in an interesting fashion,
which
that hasn't been done the Saw films.
Hasn't been done previously.
Yep. Mine would be.
Yep.
Four hippos. Chained to each one of your legs and your arms, and then you put four troughs out, and they've got.
How is that fair in any way?
If you can convince the hippos to go the other way, you're out. The one of them's got a key strapped to it.
Getting executed, Dr. fucking Doolittle. Fuck. Can Dr. Doolittle even talk to hippos?
Yeah. Didn't talk to all animals.
All animals, sorry. Yeah.
Come on, then, what are you hitting us with? That was off the top of my head. You've been we've paused it for 20 minutes, he still hasn't come up with anything.
So I like the idea of like...
God, it's getting steamy, isn't it? I'm steaming up here.
There we go. Something to do with heat. Oh, heat's been done before.
What about?
Oh, someone having to scalp yourself or something like that.
That's been done before.
Has it?
Probably. Sandpaper.
Lose your eyes. It's been done before.
Eat. A lot.
Eat. What a terrible cry about.
You've got to eat 200 chicken nuggets or you die.
200 chicken nuggets. Have you got to keep it down?
Yes.
Oh my, there you go, there's the challenge.
Right, anyway.
Thanks for thinking of both of my
Moving
ideas.
Hit us with another one.
Die Hard.
I'll definitely give you that one.
Making another one, I think.
We've definitely got to do Die Hard with a Vengeance, though. We haven't done it yet. It's one of my favourite films of all time.
Okay. Even though I think the first one's better.
I've got one for you, beat. Jumanji.
Good point, but is it
really
a good
franchise?
We haven't seen the
film. It hasn't come out yet.
There's only been two previously.
What was the other one?
Zafura.
Ah.
Indiana Jones. I just see you tapping away on your iPad.
See more time, creepy on code.
Why does Harrison Ford keep on making all the films worse?
Why does he not want to do any more Star Wars, but will quite happily do Indiana Jones?
It makes zero sense.
I don't understand it. Like,
it's like he's going to come back as the president, Air Force One, or whatever.
He hid in the fucking fridge.
Oh my god.
Anyway, American Pie.
Like it. Stifler. What happened to Stifler?
I don't know.
He needs money.
Can you think of anything off the top of your head, Pete?
Off the top of my head?
Any franchise that should have died? Tron?
Definitely.
Do you think the new one? One two films. The new one's shit.
I like the new. No, it's absolutely terrible.
Do you reckon?
Yeah.
They bring another one out as well.
Pan?
What?
Peter Pan?
Alright.
I only thought of that because the lead actor in Tron is in the new Peter Pan film, right. And it's fucking dog shit.
What about when James Franco and Seth Rogen and all them get together? Can we class that as a franchise?
Any sort of.
To be fair, I like them.
Judd Apatow.
Yeah. No. That brings an end to not necessarily top five franchise that won't or wouldn't die. And going on to our next segment, Beetroot. True or false trivia.
Oh.
In this segment, we've got some beautiful trivia from a popular movie website. But I've thrown a couple of red herrings in to try and catch Beat out. Let's see how many he can get right. Beat, straight away. Out of the film's $300 million budget, $250 million was spent on green screen CGI.
True.
False, $250 million out of $300 million. You've got to pay actors and sets and everything.
It fooled me out.
You feel straight away.
Right, so how much is Ben Affleck getting for this?
Well, I don't know, but...
$10
million? Give over. He's got to be paid more than that, hasn't he?
$10 million for each of them, John.
Do you reckon?
Less, I don't know.
Probably I. Is that how much an actor makes?
I don't know how much the actors are paid. They can't be paid $10 million, can they?
They've got to be paid around that, like...
Really?
I think so, yeah, definitely.
I have no idea. I have no concept of how much an actor is paid.
So, Pete, out of $300 million budget, you've seen the film and you thought $250 million was spent on green screen
CGI.
Yeah,
yeah.
Okay, you're not even bothered you got that one wrong,
you just might have fucking convinced me.
Next one, Pete. Danny Elfman took over from Junkie XL.
Junkie XL!
Who originally replaced Hans Zimmer, who announced his retirement from the superhero business. And left to work on Tomb Raider. True or false?
True. Like, that is ridiculous. Hans Zimmer, I scoff at these superhero movies. Off to the video games. You know what I mean?
He's like, I'm not doing any of these superhero... Get my name off these superhero movies. Hans, do you fancy doing a Tomb Raider reboot?
Oh, sign me up, yeah.
How much?
$500 billion.
$800 million.
For the best soundtrack you can give us.
$800 million to check your B-sides and see if you've got anything that works in the jungle.
Do, do, do. Superman theme insert here, joke.
So true or false, true or false, Pete?
True.
Boom. In this universe, Batman is a normal man in a suit who enjoys Mercedes, drinking, and hanging out with friends.
True.
That's false.
What?
He's not really, is he? But that's what he comes across
that's
like.
That's literally what he is.
I know, but that's not what they set out to do. That's my opinion.
I mean, that's not fair at all.
In this universe, Batman is a normal man in a suit who enjoys Mercedes, drinking, and hanging out with friends.
And it's completely nothing like Batman.
Right, okay, moving on, Beat. We'll leave that for Batman discussion in main discussion. Putty was used for characters in numerous wide shots.
Putty? What does that mean?
Clear.
It's true. It's so true. Oh my god. It's so true.
True or false?
So true.
False.
I know.
CGI rubber men.
CGI rubber people everywhere. That's actually really interesting because Wonder Woman's origins, she was made out of clay. Can you believe
the fucking clear point? Oh my god, this is going south. I apologise.
Wow.
Oh, our production value has gone down.
Oh, not as much as fucking just these $300 million budget has.
Next one, Pete. Lawrence Fishburne was asked to reprise the role of Pennywise for a cameo, but scheduling conflicts with other projects made him unavailable on the day film was supposed to take place.
Agreed on.
That's true.
Well done.
Did you miss Perry White?
I was waiting for like an end credit scene.
He's a regular feature in the Talking Crass universe, Perry White.
He is. He's a judge of quality.
Oh my god, I need a chuckle of coffee. Next one, mate. Billy Crudup plays Barry Allen's dad, Henry, in this film. However, before appearing in the DC Universe, Crudup initially auditioned for and was a top contender for the role of Bruce Wayne, Batman, in Batman Begins before Bale got it.
True.
Enjoyed with Billy Crudup, B?
Love him. He's a good...
Have you got points on him when we're going to main points?
None at all.
Are you going to talk about
him? I've got no points. I'm going to talk about him. I've got no points.
Okay, fair enough.
Good Watchman. What's he called, Mr...
Dr. Manhattan.
Is it Dr. Manhattan?
I think so.
Okay. Yeah, he's great as that.
Weird. In The Watchman, how his penis is out.
Aye, very weird. Very weird indeed.
Very weird.
I think that's in the comics, though.
Is it?
Mm-hmm. It's got obviously...
Why does he have a slanger out there? Like?
It's going to symbolise something, hasn't it? The fact that he's really just a man.
All right. Beat, last point.
Slanger.
We flew through these. Lana Wachowski and Lily Wachowski were, at one point, considered to direct the film.
Wow, what would that turn out as? False, as much as I like the idea. It's too creative.
True.
Oh, I hear giving Warner Brothers that credit.
Would you like to see the two girls direct this?
Definitely.
Me too.
Come on, John.
Beat, that brings an end, dude.
Dr. One Manhattan.
That brings an end to True or False Trivia. And now, we're at the main point we've all been waiting for. Since me and B got out of the cinema, we've wanted to talk about this film. And we've kept it for now. So, what we'd like to say is, spoilers throughout. If you haven't seen the film, don't listen. Get out.
Goodbye.
Get out now. Right, B, so I've got some general points down here which we can discuss.
Right. No.
No.
Aye, sure, of course.
So what did you think of the storyline? What did you think of...
First point of the movie.
The plot of the film, B.
First point of the movie, right? And I preface this by saying, mm-hmm. It's not to offend anyone who enjoys the movie. It's just my point of view.
Maybe we're being a bit snobbish.
It's not snobbish, it's fucking trash.
Okay.
But here's the point I'm making. The perfect movie if you're under the age of 12. Smelled like George Lucas took a big shit on it. Get that feeling or not?
Yes.
The perfect...
I very, very thought... It's a kid's film.
The executive scientific money-making kid's scheme from all the suits.
Do you know what it is, though, Bede?
Batman is a dumbed-down, regular human character who makes stupid little jokes all the time. That works with kids. Focus group work there will make 5 million out of that. Keep that in.
That's a fucking joke. But you know how Bale's Batman films, like,
yes,
Nolan's Batman films,
mm-hmm,
got hammered for not being a superhero film?
Yes.
Do you know what I mean?
No, I think that's what makes it good. It's quite drama-ish.
Is it a Batman film? Obviously it's a Batman film, but is it?
Is the focus of it a Batman film? Is it a comic book film?
Is it a comic book film?
No.
Is that Batman portrayed in the comics like that?
I think the characterizations are strong,
mm-hmm,
but I think it's a thriller.
Crime thriller?
A crime thriller?
I'd probably say that.
With the visual makeup of a superhero movie.
Like The Dark Knight's one of our favourite films.
I mean, purely by tone.
I love Batman.
So serious tone-wise.
I enjoy Batman. I enjoyed the comic book run of Batman.
Right.
Sorry, not the comic book.
The comic book run of Batman. Who could forget the Batman?
The Batman comic book run. Sorry. The TV show, cartoon. I enjoyed
Batman the Animated Series, right.
I enjoyed it.
I enjoyed it. That is Batman to me.
Yeah.
That is my Batman. You got the character well done there.
So basically, the plot of the film is Superman's died. The world's lost all hope. Villains are starting to rise again. Bruce Wayne wants to get a squad together just in case anything kicks off.
Yes. Parademons are just flying about.
Parademons are just randomly flying about.
Can I stop you in your tracks, John?
Yep, yeah, I'm just going to roll. If you've got anything to say while I'm doing
first
this,
you point, problem. Really. Mm-hmm. The whole plot collapses in on itself due to the whole thing hinging on the excuse that Superman was an inspiration after his death. Mm-hmm. Completely forced rather than felt. Agree?
Mm-hmm.
So the whole hinge of this movie is that Batman is so distraught that this powerful hope symbol got destroyed and we are now lost without him. But... He was a murderous psychopath who snapped necks and cashed checks. That doesn't work. You know what I mean?
I think
he wasn't hopeful at all.
They were kicking off because he killed a lot of people, didn't he?
It was so fucking dumb. Ruined by its previous film.
Yeah.
The whole thing collapses.
Beats that we jump to Femascara.
Yes.
And the mother box is shaken.
So, it introduces us to the most basic plot layout of all time. Here's our MacGuffin. This is an object which the bad guy needs. There are three of them. He is the one, he's the other one, he's the third one. All come together, bad things happen. As basic and as easy to understand for your little 12-year-old mind in the world. And obviously this occurs in other films, right? It's a big blue laser in the Avengers. Mm-hmm. It's a big blue laser in this one as well. But it's almost the focus. You know, when I don't like a film, I really pinpoint stuff like that.
Yeah.
What a load of shit. So
absolutely horrendous.
You know,
it was full. It might as well have been a video game.
Clear women everywhere.
It might as well have been a video game.
I think Zack Snyder's come under scrutiny a lot.
I think they've patched this together, beat. I think there hasn't been a director there. Josh Whedon. Joss Whedon's come in. I think they've patched it together with a lot of this video stuff.
This feels very Snyder.
Do you think?
I think he's come under previously. He's come under a lot of scrutiny.
He enjoys CGI, doesn't he?
He's come under a lot of scrutiny due to his portrayal of women in film.
Right.
Over-sexualised husks of their actual representations. Not very,
right. Which,
you know, interesting or naturally strong.
See, Wonder Woman kicked that into the fucking back street. You
I was
going mean?
To make the opinion that if you compared the scenes from Wonder Woman and the scenes of Femascara here, it is just two different movies. So all I can see from Wonder Woman is some kind of nice choreographed kind of... It's quite heavy CGI.
Where did they shoot Wonder Woman?
I don't know. Probably on a green screen, but it's better. It looked like less use of
the
budget.
I didn't make these points in Wonder Woman. Wonder Woman's one of my favourite films of the year.
All I can see from this film is when them two large women smashed the big hammers into the poles and the queen did that stupid fucking roll underneath the stones.
What about when the horse got wiped out by Steppenwolf?
Oh my god, I burst out into tears though.
Anyway, Femascara's on Earth, I think, isn't it?
Right.
I don't know.
No. Steppenwolf has to get three boxes together. One box is at Femascara. Go to that fucking place. It's total shit CGI fest. Mm-hmm. The characters are just... It's just a mess. It's comical.
Whip through a beat and then we'll just get the point.
He ends up getting the box. Femascara's firing arrow. We get the Wonder Woman scene. Bing, bang, bang.
We know this flaming building tells me that we need to go and sort shit out. Did you enjoy it? Was there any good aspects of watching this film?
I'm trying to think of other superhero films and if the story is the strongest element and whether if it doesn't hold up, the movie completely fails because of that. Because usually the story in superhero films mm-hmm. are pretty flimsy.
Right.
Obviously all...
It's the characters. Characters over plot.
I guess. So the main thing I draw from it is characterisation
okay.
of these superheroes.
I thought the plot was absolutely awful. Didn't have us at all. I just thought it was stupid. And we might as well just go on to talk about the Justice League.
Aye, big time.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we're going through the characters. B, we'll start off with the man, the myth, the legend. Ben Affleck's Batman.
Right.
What do you think, Bede?
Hate it now.
Right. Did you like it before?
No.
Has it been an absolute car crash?
So the crack is, right?
Wait there. Army Hammer was originally sounded out. What do you think of that?
I've got no problems with Ben Affleck being Batman.
Right.
Batman.
Binman.
But the direction of the character, the scenes he's in, mm-hmm. the way he acts, the thing he does, not good at all.
Can I throw a few points in, babe?
Yes.
This Batman seems like he's a very heavy drinker.
Not in this film.
He had a whiskey before he was meant to go and save the world.
What?
The share of whiskey.
The bourbon!
Beat the share of whiskey. What do you think of that? He had wine in the cellar on the last... In the last film, we had a full stock wine cellar. I don't know, I don't know, mate.
So for me, a massive character, very close to my heart. Ben Affleck. Not to fault, but is he? Should he have more strength when he's being directed to do certain things that the character wouldn't? If you loved a character, would you go, I am not doing that, that is out of character for Batman?
Pete, was it all bullshit about him saying that he's a Batman fan?
No, I do.
Is he actually a Batman fan?
I do believe that because...
Did he say that because he wanted the role and the money?
I do believe that because that has also been confirmed by... who's the fat guy?
With a beard.
Kevin Smith.
Kevin Smith, yeah.
He's a good friend of Ben Affleck's, I think, who backs that statement up.
It makes us so sad. This makes me so sad. No wonder he wants out. No wonder he wants out these films.
So little stuff like, first gripe, costume.
I don't like it at all.
You've gone from
it's
having,
leather.
For me,
it's fucking leather.
For me, right, the Batman vs Superman costume of Batman is the best you're ever going to get. The absolute pinnacle of design for a Batman.
You think?
For me personally, the grey suit, how hard that is to do. A grey Batman suit, you look like a fucking idiot.
Right, okay.
He looked like... a demon, right? Mm-hmm. That's Batman. He scares you, even though he's wearing tights.
Right.
It's a complete contradiction I love. Right?
Yep.
The ears. Nice and short and stubby.
Nice
and
stubby.
He had a big square head that looked like if you threw him through a wall, it wouldn't phase him one bit.
Better than Michael Keaton's ears.
Better than Michael Keaton's ears.
Which were the longest things I've ever seen.
Prod your eyes out. If you're offset... Oh, no, well, his head was attached via rubber. It was moulded into the helmet, so it doesn't matter anyway. But in this film, the curve that is made them a bit longer, pointing them a bit forward. They look fucking dumb. They give them stupid arm slits all over his body. And it just didn't work for us. I do not like the redesign. Also, the armoured version later on the film that comes in. I fucking hate glasses on Batman. That's Owlman's thing. Obviously, it's been brought up by loads of people.
Why does Batman wear glasses in the comics? At points.
What, I mean, probably just one slate of a comic. One image.
He looks fucking ridiculous.
He looks like Owlman out of Watchmen.
He does, aye. Is that Zack Snyder?
Zack Snyder gets a hard-on for these, like... He loves religious imagery. And goggles and film. Right?
you've heard it in your first, Beatle. Zack Snyder loves religious imagery. And goggles in film.
Right. Another thing, which I forgot to bring up, but you brought it up. I forgot about it. Right. He drinks bourbon... Mm-hmm. The whiskey in the film he has a dislocated shoulder because Superman returns.
One of them puts it back in.
Yes.
Then he goes and has a drink before he's like, we need to do this tonight. We need to get this done.
This is Batman. He's the peak. This is my Batman.
Right.
The peak of physical fitness and mental fitness. Cracking an arm back into position, he wouldn't fucking look in 2 seconds. He'd just grimace and go, had to be done. He'd probably do it himself off a wall because he knows the kind of, the way you need to prop an arm against a wall to do it yourself.
I want to say, right, that not only is this the weakest Batman portrayal I've ever seen.
Yes.
It's the weakest superhero portrayal I've ever seen in a film.
Right.
He's, like I said, in True or False Trivia, he's a guy who likes Mercedes.
Yes.
Drinking.
Yeah.
And hanging out with friends.
Right.
That's it. That's it. Even as Bruce Wayne isn't the cheaty chappy wanting to get with lasses or girls. You know.
It isn't the facade.
There's not even the facade
there. That massively up.
He's like, I don't want a girlfriend.
Aye.
He's just boring. Out the suit is what he is in the suit.
That's exactly right. And he should be out of the suit. He should be metaphorically.
Charismatic.
He metaphorically in a suit. He's always way too happy.
Exactly.
And as soon as he goes behind closed doors, he's a slate of fucking fear.
Like, Bale did it really well.
Bale never smiled once he was in Peter Hammer, smiled with Alfred.
Peter Hammer, Bale's Batman.
I think it can be hammered. I think his Batman is bad, but...
His Bruce Wayne is untouchable. Class. Absolutely great. Any other points on Batman? I think we've
uses
rounded up
guns.
There.
Right, so
that stupid fucking gun.
So the problem is with this argument, it's a different universe and a different version of the character.
So does that condone it, Pete?
But how far away from the fundamentals which make a character good do you step away and use that excuse? You know, I like the character of Batman because of these things. He doesn't kill.
Pete, I know.
He uses fear and darkness.
Right. I know it's hard in this film where they're fighting otherworldly beings.
And he has killed before. He'll kill parademons. But
they're all fighting Steppenwolf, and he was struggling with one parademon.
Yes.
Like for about 5 minutes of the film.
He's so weak.
He's just such a weak portrayal. And if he hasn't got a vehicle, what's the point of him being there?
And Batman, in the comics, has killed. Because it's a sentience thing. Like,
he can just put one punch into it and just blow it up, you know what I mean? he's a karate master, you know what I mean?
No. So he'll kill something if he believes it has no ability for good.
Right, if it's... Right.
But that's after the fact we've seen him not killing. This is the first two films we've really seen him in Shine. You know, Batman v Superman and this. Mm-hmm. And then we haven't seen him not kill.
So what's...
Are you not used guns?
What's going on with the... So is the new Batman film after this? Because I thought they would have just done a prequel.
Who knows how?
Because they keep saying that he's been doing this for 20 years.
I have no idea.
It would be nice to go back, where dye his hair, make him look a little bit younger. Do you know what I mean? Right, next one, Wonder Woman. What do you think of portrayal in this?
I like
fine. I thought she was fine.
Fine. I like Wonder Woman, but it's so blatant that the directors, be it Joss Whedon's good with female leads, mm-hmm. a lack of understanding on how to handle the character.
Maybe.
I'm just comparing it to Wonder Woman. Is that okay to do? Mm-hmm. All I see is just stupid fucking pieces of dialogue that don't work. And stupid fucking clear rubber man running all over.
Do you know the thing where she bangs her wristbands together?
Yes.
That looked weakened in this film?
Overused.
Overused and weak?
It's like the lightsaber effect. You keep a lightsaber for the rarest of battles.
Yes, right.
You ignite a lightsaber, and the more you do it in a film, the less value it has.
Yes, yeah.
You keep it for two times in the film.
I totally get that, totally get that.
The van braces, or whatever you want to call them, they've got a special name, I don't know the name.
RuneScape.
Exactly. They get used 15 fucking times, and it gets a little tiresome. I think that's a show stealer. You know, in WWE wrestling, when the final signature move, it doesn't get used 5 times in the start, unless you're Roman Reigns. But you know what I mean? I get that feeling. Anyway, that's...
We'll just say she was fine.
She's good. I love Gal Gadot, and I like the character.
One of our friends who came and saw it with us was laughing his back off, because she can't pronounce thought properly.
She
says fart every time she says thought. That's the type of guys we are, and we're not about with people.
Yes.
Anyway, moving on. Aquaman.
Good.
Enjoyed him.
But...
And by far the best thing in the film.
You know what I could have done with? Some type of... if only they had some sort of system of making solo movies before they made the big ensemble one. What franchise could do... Oh, wait, Marvel do it. Can we have an Aquaman film to introduce the character so we're not bogged down in all this shit?
We're introducing the character in 5 minutes.
It's so fucking stupid, how?
Ridiculous. Momoa does the best he can.
I like Momoa.
I can imagine a lot of people don't like it because he's probably the antithesis to what a normal Aquaman... cut blonde haired warrior
I think
who
that's what these,
is very much down the line is a bit of it's like a bit
that
of a
used
satire.
To be the status quo, but comic writers have written him a bit more in that knowledge of like, I'm not that goody two shoes, but he's still got a
like
short
a bit of a Viking hair, type thing,
but he will change to suit Momoa, obviously. Right, okay. Comics always do that. I like him though.
Cyborg beat
better than what I thought. I was massively turned off by the trailers.
Do you think they eradicated a few scenes where he looked like a skeleton in it?
I think what happened.
There's a few trailer scenes where I think what happened, that suit, it was like he was like a skeleton in some scenes when he had the joggers on and the hoodie.
Yeah, he's
he was
bulked
like,
out.
Bulk?
Well, what they did there was they saved on money because they didn't want to spend loads on CGI full body.
So just put him in joggers.
So they put him in joggers.
Slacks, put him in
which
slacks.
Which I love. I give the film the credit there. What happened?
That's just because you're a massive fan of joggers.
I am, of course. You look like Slim Shady. What happens is, trailers usually are unfinished CGI before the film's released.
Right, okay.
So before they've put the money in, that they spend less on the trailer footage.
Right, okay.
So I think that's why it looked worse. Mm-hmm. But the characterization of Cyborg, for me, there's a show used to come out, it was Teen Titans, I think it was called.
When he says Booyah, it's in order to that.
Like, the character I have was a lot more fun than the one portrayed there, but it wasn't bad.
Very moody, wasn't he? Really moody. He got better.
It was a bit better. There was a bit of fun in there, like the scene when he's starting to Superman. He's like, "Oh, I didn't feel me toes and shit like that." That was pretty fun. I'll give him that. So he actually impressed us a bit. Okay. I quite like the character.
Did you enjoy the Flash?
Flash, for me personally, the best part of the film.
Yeah, I agree.
Mile.
I thought Ezra Miller nailed it.
Ezra Miller is fucking great. Obviously, we need to talk about Kevin. we need to talk about the movie because it's fucking good.
When you said that, I was like, well, who's Kevin? No, I was like, he's classic.
We do need to talk about Kevin Spacey. No, my joke.
Let's move on.
But a lot of people.
I enjoyed Ezra Miller. I enjoyed the Flash.
A lot of people give the costume flack.
The costume?
Yeah. Funny enough, I actually like the design.
It looked a lot similar to the TV show one. Everyone buzzes off the TV show.
It's nothing like the TV show one.
Is it not?
Nothing like it at all.
It was red and had things on the side.
I mean, that's the Flash, but this is quite space shuttle-y, wires everywhere.
Right.
But the other one's quite like a cloth, full leotard kind of thing.
That would not have looked good.
Maybe not. It's hard to do.
You would have rather seen him in
a Flash.
You'd have rather seen him in a cloth leotard.
It's hard to do the Flash because the original is.
I thought the suit looked badass.
I thought it looked really good. A lot of people give it flat though.
Look, it's 2017. We're not in the '60s.
Goddamn, John. We're making points and then contradicting them with sentences later on.
Beat.
Yes.
Let's go on to it.
What?
The main part of the film, the return of Superman.
Okay.
As a Justice League member.
Boy, oh boy, have we got points to make here.
Beat what I say to you before we went in and saw the film.
I can't wait to see Superman. If it's one thing they do in this film, I'll give it a 10 out of 10 if Superman returns right at the bad time of the third act and comes in with the Hans Zimmer theme and saves the day.
That's
disregarding the film.
Surely, Beat, right? I know Hans Zimmer's pulled out this film, but they've got the rights to use that Man of Steel soundtrack, haven't they?
I have no idea.
Surely. They've got to have.
I have no idea.
They mustn't have. That's why they must have eradicated it.
It could depend on the contract Zimmer signed. He could say, I keep all intellectual properties.
Well, that's probably why he's done, because that's probably why it was in the film. And, and it died because
it was
of
in the trailer.
Well, I was. So why did they... Right, the worst part of this film for me is the way that they brought Superman back. Why? You kill him in the last film. Batman vs Superman, you kill Embiid, and you bring him back like this by using the mother box, which they need to really keep safe. But what we'll do is we'll use it to bring back Superman, and then just throw the mother box out the building, and let Steppenwolf come get
it. Is that what happened?
It went on a card.
I was that annoyed at the way they brought back Superman. I had to just take my brain out for a couple of seconds.
Why? Someone mocked up him in the black suit with a beard as well. By the
way,
and he looked unreal.
Can you believe they didn't do the black suit?
I'm gonna find the picture and I'm gonna post it on the tags.
Right.
He looks fucking incredible. Someone mocked up the black suit with a beard, Henry Cavill in a beard, and it looked incredible.
Can you believe they didn't do?
Could you not have just said the sun woke him up a little bit, then he went into space, some shit like that, and then he comes and he comes and saves the day out of nowhere. We're not expecting it. And
full reveal when he can you not?
He comes in. He's it's like that.
The Spielberg.
When he's up in the sky.
Yes.
In the sun.
He blots the sun out, and you see his outline, the silhouette of his.
It could have been so beautiful. And then what happens at the end? Rather than Jorty, he just is Superman.
And people go, and that Batman goes, what? No, so Cyborg's like, what's that? And Batman goes, hope. And he fucking comes down.
Guess what, Beat?
What?
Superman does the right thing because that's what Superman does. You don't need to convince him to do shit. It's the right thing to do, so he's going to do it. Simple as. Pisses me off. Superman's one of my favourite characters in any
medium,
comic or anything. I love Henry Cavill, by the way.
Great choice.
I love him.
I
enjoy him, but he's getting misused.
Bogged
massively.
Down.
I've got some points on it, Beat, anyway.
Okay.
So, why did they use the mother box to bring back Superman? We've discussed.
Hate it.
Why was Superman dressed like the Hulk? You made a point on this. Like, he has a fight in, like, ripped trousers.
Shot. I guess it's to distance him. It's, like, to cause a juxtaposition between suited blue man, hopeful Superman, and this mental, weird, corpse-ridden, I forgot who you were.
What a stupid fucking idea.
It's a terrible idea. It's a really bad idea.
My last point, Beat. Why did Lois say that he smelled nice after he's been dead for a year? What was that all about?
It was a bit of a Thor Ragnarok where you're looking for that serious, nice, delicate, emotional moment and it's broken with a stupid fucking line.
I got a little bit emotional when Martha turned up.
I did, but then Danny Elfman's awful, boring, bland score did not hit the Zimmer note.
You know this film, Beat? If this was on sci-fi...
Yes. I wouldn't watch it.
It strikes me as it's a 300 million film.
It's a
300 million film. If this was on sci-fi and you watch it, you'd be like, all right, yeah, I understand why this is on sci-fi. It's a fucking joke. Anyway, Beat, that's the end of the points of the Justice League members. Do you want to want the villain Steppenwolf?
Okay.
What do you think of Steppenwolf be?
CGI.
I thought he was probably the weakest comic book villain portrayal in film I've ever seen.
No, I think that's harsh.
You think it's harsh?
I like the actor.
He's on par with Bosk's elf out of Thor. Do you know the elf? Chris Eccleston.
The white elf guy.
He's on par with him.
I didn't even watch that.
He wasn't strong, I don't think. He got beaten pretty easily by all the Justice League members when they were together.
I liked his motivation.
What was his motivation?
He was seeking redemption for failing taking over a world.
Okay, I'll give you that.
I like the idea that he is not acting out of pure evil, but a quite human instinct of wanting to go back to your family. Other than that, there's literally nothing interesting about him, other than his voice and the bit in the trailer which the Spoilweather said, why do you people keep saying that? When he says, oh, we have families. Very, I quite like that.
It's very, very hard to portray, see in this day and age where we're having to have these big, big bads to face all of the superheroes.
To give them complex adult themes where you need a little child brain to understand motivations.
And I think it's very hard to just do a CGI villain.
Oh, full CGI.
I'm not having it.
These companies feel convinced that it can work.
I don't understand
who's given them the memo that they think it's good.
Who played him?
The guy who played... What's his... Man's Raider in Game of Thrones.
Man's Raider.
All right. He's great.
He's had no experience working on CGI. Like, he's got no experience in it.
All right.
He had to go and speak to Liam Neeson, who's his mate. Anyway, there you go. So Steppenwolf, instantly forgettable. That's my opinion
instantly.
On him.
Instantly. So bland. It could have been the guy at the end of Wonder Woman.
It's like... we'll put this generic villain in just to set up the Justice League franchise, which is now dead, by the way,
Can we just reboot it, but keep Henry Cavill and Ezra Miller and Gal Gadot and...
Can we get Christopher Nolan to do a Superman film?
I don't want that tone. I don't want real world. I want superheroes, but I want Batman to be the ultimate knowing, intelligent god that he is. Mm-hmm. He's got every position planned. I want Wonder Woman to be as strong as she is. Actually, Wonder Woman's great. I think the character's great. Bang on. Flash was bang on for me. But I just don't like the over-reliance on CGI. Can we have a smaller scale? Yeah. Smaller scale, practical set, and just a nice little moment. Do you know what I mean? GLA, John. Justice League Unlimited. Cartoon series, followed on from the animated Batman series. Absolutely me keystone for going off characterisation and what is good as a Justice League film. Because I don't read comics. I go off that.
Beat, a little point I want to throw in.
Yes.
What was the crap with that family that's in a house?
Oh my God.
Why was that a good idea to put in the film?
So as a motivation for the heroes, as an audience, to feel tension, something to lose. Because... Mm-hmm. Obviously, they can't kill Superman again, because that's already fucking happened. So the threat is one family. See, Superman later saves a whole building of people.
Yeah, which
but
is
I
great.
Didn't have any... We didn't get one bit of... why didn't
Might
the
as well
film,
have just been a building.
Why didn't they film the building with all the people in hanging from outside the windows, rather than this one stupid little fucking family, where they got... You know why? They wanted a jump scare in the film.
The window 100%. Jump scare.
Or it relates back to my point that this is for 12-year-olds, and 12-year-olds go, oh my God, that's me. I'm in a family like that. That's what I feel like.
Okay.
I'm in trouble. Whereas, as an adult, I'm like, one family, that's all the fucking saving. Batman was trying to pep talk, Flash into saving people, while people were getting struggled by thinking killed.
By the way, what happened to the...
Batman let someone die because Steppenwolf snapped the neck.
What happened to Cyborg's dad?
I have no fucking idea.
He's not dead. He got
Is
saved.
He not dead?
He got saved by the Flash.
All right. Well, they didn't save the other scientists where Batman was taunting the Flash. Save one. This guy's just snapping the neck of this woman.
Could Flash have not just come in now?
I mean, I understand he's never done that, but can we have the pep talk before they go into that scene where the woman dies because of Batman not doing anything?
Fair enough.
Can Batman not have a moment where he walks in and goes to Steppenwolf and just dismantles him? That, you know that moment where Batman's a human being, they have this 12-foot god.
He knows how to kill Steppenwolf.
Batman is 15 steps ahead of him in the chess game. And everything Steppenwolf's saying, Batman's knocking back. And you're like, Batman's going to fucking ruin him. And the villain doesn't even know.
No,
we never have that hubris. We never have that hubris.
This Batman waits for Superman to turn up and then smiles.
And he makes a stupid fucking joke and goes, he is tall. It's like, maybe you might make a joke, but oh my god, my characterisation.
He was there for There's No One Loves Batman more than you, babe.
I love Batman so much.
He was there for comedy effect.
He was in a film, and he didn't even do much.
Good now. He's the driver. That's what he is.
The explanation is that he's the one who gathers the team together, but that's bullshit. You know what I mean?
I mean, is he that weak in the Justice League? The cartoon series.
He's strong as fuck, like massively overpowered.
Because I'm trying to use. I'm trying to use an excuse of, he's in this world of aliens
and he can't do anything because he's human.
But that's just a shit excuse.
The character is. The fact that he is human makes him super powered. He is beyond these super beings. That's what's interesting about him.
It's getting us angry, baby.
Also, he's a complete fucking idiot. When he's talking to Aquaman, there's a Scandinavian kind of feel about the language.
Yep.
And he never uses that.
You made a good point.
Batman is the smartest human being on this earth, other than Superman, because Superman's got an alien brain.
Yes, mate.
He would know every language ever. And he'd be like, boom, 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 I can... And then you don't get that kind of cliche. It's cliche, of course, but you know that moment when people are speaking in another language have that reveal of knowing what they're saying.
I'm all for jokiness and stuff like that and big comedy effect, but you had that of Flash and Jason Momoa, Aquaman.
Yes, that's it. Flash is a comedy relief.
Isn't Batman just always down the line?
And he has one joke right at the end after all the business
when it's
is done.
Chill, exactly.
And he's like, oh my god, Batman makes jokes. I didn't know that. He's actually lighter than a dark brooding hero he is. But it's not every 5 minutes. And he's also meant to be really smart, intelligent, 15 moves ahead of everyone else. And sometimes them plans fall through because he is human. But knowing the fact that the plans are there is what interests me about
bouncing back to Superman beat as well.
Yes.
Do you know when he came back and he went crazy? And the parademons were going about.
Right.
I was thinking what Captain Batman vs Superman when Batman had the flash forward. Or was it a flashback? Or was was it a different universe? I don't know what happened.
I have no idea what that was in context.
It looked like they were setting up that. A little bit.
How come parademons are just flying about the world just randomly?
Chernobyl.
Well done.
They're coming out of that pipe in Chernobyl, aren't they?
Were they?
Apparently.
Why was one in Gotham? And why was everyone okay with that?
Hey, anyway, Mark's the guy on Mindhunter. We're giving honourable mention earlier.
Honourable mention.
And he makes a little cameo.
I was expecting him to turn out to be like a...
Unreal.
A rogue of Batman, but he never did. Might later on. He'll probably be revealed.
So, I'll go into my likes that I've got written down here.
Okay, likes.
Jason Momoa.
Yes.
Pete Lou made adverts. For the film.
Yes,
to get us there.
Absolutely. The adverts were much better than the film.
When Gal Gadot says thought, it sounded like fart. And that's me likes for the film, baby. What's yours?
Likes for the film for me. Flash, 100% best thing in the film.
Yeah, I agree with you there.
A little bit of a better understanding for Superman being a hopeful beacon. A little bit better.
Can we just have a solo Superman film next, please?
One more like was... The bit where the Flash and the Superman raced.
That was cool at the end, yeah, I like that.
An actual practical set for once. A little bit right at the start when they're talking, then obviously goes into Super CGI mode.
Yep.
Wonder Woman is always good. I enjoy the character. Although the overuse of her powers got a bit dry.
Mm-hmm.
Clear model. Oh, I'll get into dislikes later on. Aquaman's good. Anything else?
I mean, my favourite bit of the film was probably when Aquaman was sitting on the whip. And he starts saying, like, you're beautiful,
that
you.
That was really funny, yeah.
And, like, I'm really scared that no one's ever wanted us and stuff like that.
Yeah, definitely.
It's really good. I'll put that in my likes as well.
But other than that, Ezra Miller, Wonder Woman, Gal Gadot, and Aquaman.
Right. My dislikes.
Dislikes, here we go.
Every reliance of CGI.
Yes, I agree.
Rubber men all over.
I agree.
Reliance of green screen.
I agree.
Luther at the end.
Terrible, get him out.
We'll talk about the end after you go through your dislikes.
Okay. Do you want my dislikes now?
I would love your dislikes, babe.
There's clear people everywhere. I completely agree. Each scene of the film at the beginning felt like a parody of a superhero film.
Someone said, on Twitter.
Yes.
The first act was... Well, the first half of the film was 7 out of 10. But the last half saved it 10 out of 10.
I don't know what that means, because 7 out of 10 is good.
10 out of 10.
10 out of 10 is the best film ever made.
Well, there you go, baby. Right, dislikes.
I appreciate that other people can have opinions. Fair play. And I hope you're not hurt by the fact that we are dismembering it. We know nothing, okay?
This
We're fucking bums.
Normally, as well.
You're probably right.
I try and pull the punches a little bit where you're a little bit more straightforward.
I'm passionate about these characters.
I can't pull the punches. I can't pull punches on this one.
It's the analogy I make, John, because I love an analogy.
Mm-hmm.
It's a pizza. Batman is a pizza. How do you ruin a pizza? How? You got bread.
Pineapple.
You got bread, sauce.
Pineapple beef.
That was not your joke.
Okay, sorry.
You got bread, sauce and cheese, right? How do you ruin a pizza? Batman's fundamentals. He doesn't kill. He's brooding all the time. He's 15 steps ahead of you, but he sometimes falls through because he's human. How do you ruin that?
They managed
to do it. They managed
to break our heartbeat.
The Themyscira scene was just a fucking...
So this is just your dislike.
Comical mess.
That was a fucking
so
mess.
So they set this little sequence up where they're trying to kind of skivvy away the cube. So it's like, oh, you know that bit in Rogue One where they're taking the data from... That how well that worked.
God, that was so beautiful in Rogue One.
Well, in this, they
Darth
fucking
Vader turns
ruined
up.
It by just making it a huge CGI fuckfest. I feel last minute rush CGI shots because they didn't have any of the parts.
There's just something that really gets on my tits about CGI horses. I don't know why. Really annoys
CGI
us.
CGI everything.
Okay.
What else? The fact that, again, you're trying to introduce all these characters' backgrounds in one film. This is the
one
Justice
film.
League film. Another
and you know they had to cut the film because Warner Brothers told them that they didn't want it run over 2 hours because of what happened Batman vs Superman.
I know. No, maybe it's because they saw the film and they went,
it's the suits,
oh,
Pete, probably.
Fuck.
Do you know what? Again, we hammer the directors.
Yes,
but it's the suits.
It's
you know
also the directors.
You learn about film.
Yeah, it's an awful world we live in.
You can only play with what you've got. No sexual innuendo there whatsoever.
I agree. Next point, Danny Elfman. Suck a fucking dick, how honestly he is awful.
Has he gone backwards, baby?
He's gone massively backwards. We had Batman, yeah. We got what's this?
The Grinch.
No,
I don't know.
Nightmare Before Christmas or something.
Yes, yeah.
Yeah, you got that one. Well done. You got Beale, anything Burton, right? You did
anything
well there.
Burton, you did well.
You're fucking way past your league now. Hans Zimmer has succeeded you. You fuck.
That's what annoyed us most about this film. My biggest dislike beat.
Yes.
Is how I had that scene played out in my head where black suited Superman comes and helps them.
Yeah.
Dun-dun. Shadowed by the sun. Getting his power back.
And
you're making his tear up beat. I'm tearing up now.
And that moment of realisation from Steppenwolf, like, what?
I can't fight
the Kryptonian was dead.
Something like
and
that.
And then he just fucking bangs him into a wall.
And that's it.
And you know what?
And then
we're like, yeah.
And then explains to the characters why he's back.
And
which is just because it's the right thing to do
I
and he's alive
again. That moment,
there
did
you
I?
Go, we didn't have it.
So another point, just getting back to the music.
And then we'll go on to the, we'll go on to wrap up the end.
Last point, the music, and if try and defy this logic. Listen to a score from Danny Elfman in this film and try and attribute it to the actual character. So we've got Wonder Woman bland theme. Sounds so similar.
Was the Wonder Woman theme in this?
A little bit.
A little bit.
And there was a little bit of John Williams Superman, a little bit of Batman.
I heard John Williams Superman.
A little bit of animated series.
As well.
Wait, what was it? I don't know. I can't remember what the animated series goes like. Fuck. Jesus Christ.
It doesn't matter. It was like... you tell you what it was? It was a diluted drink. It was me having a vodka and orange when I'm at the bottom of the bottle. That's what it was.
It was all so similar. That's the point I'm making. It's all similar shit. Fuck you, Danny Elfman.
This is a guy.
Why
you
called
really
Elfman? Why have you got Elfman
in
your name?
We can't say that to people.
We can't. You've got a lot of money.
Okay, fair enough. Well, that's what Beat said. I didn't say that.
Yeah, I said it.
Going to the final bit of the film, Beat.
Yes.
If there's a mid-credit scene, there's a post-credit scene.
Okay, I wouldn't talk about that, yeah, definitely.
What did you think of those scenes?
What was the first mid-credits,
the flashing Superman.
Literally my favourite scene in the film.
I'd go with that, I thought it was a great scene.
Obviously, when it's been done in the Justice League animated series, mm-hmm. So much better.
And comic book Superman 199.
Well done.
To find out who is the fastest man on Earth.
I like it. But if you go on YouTube, we'll may link it. Justice League animated series, the way that is done, I don't know if it's the voice actors or my childhood nostalgia, it just works. And I don't know, it evoked that again. Okay. Henry Cavill looked like Superman, Flash
looked like
Flash.
Having a good time?
Yes, he looked hopeful. And it looked fun, but true fun, not forced jive.
Did we mention the start of the film when they're doing that, the kids taking the video of Superman.
Yes.
And they've CGI'd his moustache off.
That was horrendous.
And then he goes, what's the favourite thing about Earth?
And well, he thinks about it.
He thinks about a cut off and it goes to Warner Brothers sign.
Yes, our friend, we went and watched the cinema, made that point.
And I think it's a great point.
It's a great point, but taking that aside for
subliminal
a bit.
Subliminal messaging
bit. I actually smiled at that bit. I really liked that little intro.
That's cool.
Again, that little images of hopeful Superman coming back. But
and then boy oh boy, we've got the post-credits scene.
Quick okay. point. Ruined the film because every bit of the film I was scanning. Rather than actually
for where they take the mustache off.
Is this a CGI mustache scene? And it didn't come. Most like
if people don't know, Henry Cavill was filming Mission Impossible 2018, like the new one that's coming out.
Yes.
And they need him back for reshoots or something.
Yeah, they did, exactly.
And he had a mustache, and Paramount wouldn't let him shave it off. So what they did is CGI the mustache off him.
So good.
So people who listen.
Don't
to
it ruins it. The film.
It ruins the film.
We're
don't
getting
do
for
it.
Eyeline. We're going for eyeline points of view. I'm looking at his goddamn lip.
Here we go. Post credit scene.
Go.
We cut to a jail, and there's a man bald, standing, face against the wall. Guard comes out. Luther, what are you doing? Guy turns around and starts laughing. I was like,
what?
Who's this guy?
Who's this guy?
Who's this guy that cast as the new Lex Luthor? And you just start laughing your tits off.
Oh my god.
Random throwaway guy.
So,
you made a good point.
What was the point? I can't even remember it.
Cranston?
Oh, I was expecting. This is it.
How perfect would it be if it was Cranston?
So the idea, my idea is, Luthor, little Jesse Eisenberg Luthor, has hired a double.
Yeah, yeah.
Which doesn't make sense at all. But if his double was Cranston.
Okay.
Bryan Cranston. And then he would take over. He's like, obviously, now that makes no fucking sense at all. What am I even talking about?
Why is it not just a different jail where his father's locked up?
How did he escape? And then how did... Why was the door open? And why did it theatrically turn around to reveal a different guy?
Anyway,
you know what I was expecting?
So he's on a board beat. And
I was expecting the whole rogues gallery.
To come and get him out.
At least the Joker in there or something like that working together.
What's happened to the Joker? They've just binned him now, have they?
Binned that fuck. But I like the balls.
Were the Joker not... Well, sorry, the Joker's probably locked up in Arkham Asylum while this is going on. But apparently, because we've seen Deathstroke now...
Yeah.
The new Batman film takes place after Justice League.
Does it?
But it's got to be, because Deathstroke's there.
Ugh.
They've introduced Deathstroke, which is so fucking stupid. It would have made more sense to just do like a prequel.
Well,
Batman
their idea is rather than actually making a fun film, solo film,
just get as much money into it as we can.
Just give 5 minutes out of a big ensemble film.
What do you think of Deathstroke look?
Unbelievable.
I thought it looked great.
Perfect. Literally perfection.
Yeah, I thought it looked great.
But what they're going to do is change it in 5 more films to something I don't like goggles on him.
As if they're keeping Jesse Eisenberg as Lex Luthor.
I almost like it of how bad a decision that is. But I'm actually happy they've stuck with him and gone. Like the Zack Snyder thing.
Can we end this franchise?
I know.
By beat final ratings.
Can we end the franchise but keep some of the good stuff like Cavill?
Would you cast Ben Affleck as a good Batman?
Yes, I would. I think he has had poor characterisation written for him and directed for
him. Well, he wants out, and there's a reason for that.
I understand.
Army Hammer, here you come. Right.
I don't know about that.
I don't know about beat.
How do you cast Batman?
Final ratings.
It's so difficult. Final ratings. Definitely Bram Stoker's Dracula, Keanu Reeves acting.
Keanu Reeves acting in Bram Stoker's Dracula.
Definitely.
I like all that beat.
Thank you very much.
There you go, Peter. That is us totally going against the grain. No nothing. Idiots, probably, you're thinking.
Oh, completely. Just our opinions.
That's our opinion on
Please
the film.
Please disagree. It Please spoiled, voice rage.
It spoiled my childhood and my love of these characters.
Massively.
Let's go to some fan questions, beat.
Go, go, go. Bring on the buzzing noise.
Beat, we've got some fan questions here.
I hope so.
Ad Boss Bounty Hunt's back. He says, "Hi, Bat Bosk here from Bristol." So many questions.
Can I be Alfred?
You can be Alfred if you can do the impression.
For Bat Bosk.
Oh, you've got to mention Rubber Alfred.
Oh my god. So literally in the cinema, I burst out laughing for 5 minutes straight.
The scene where they get in
the Justice League
plane.
Are taken away from the Bat plane and they couldn't get Jeremy Irons on scene.
To just stand there on a pier.
On a pier of some sort. So the completely rubber mandem. And you just went over. It's just rubber. And I just cracked open. Because I couldn't stop the words coming at my head of rubber Jeremy Irons.
And you made a point of how's he even in film?
How's he in film? Because he has major backlash of disliking gay marriage or something
it's
like
ridiculous.
That. I could be completely wrong there. I'm sure I saw that in an interview.
Right. Is Batfleck the best Batman Bosk's first question.
Batman.
Is he the best Batman?
So, the scenes in Batman v Superman, you know, where it goes into Batman version, where he goes to save Martha.
Yeah.
That's the best Batman I've ever seen. But he's so badly written as a character, I can't back it up. So no, he's not the best Batman.
Not for me either. I'd probably say Michael Keaton.
I'd go Keaton Batman-wise as well, yeah.
Although my favourite film's The Dark Knight. But
Bruce Wayne?
I think, anyway.
Bruce Wayne?
I also forgot to make a point, B, that I enjoyed Batman vs Superman better than this film.
Yes, me too, I did as well.
And that's saying something.
Did they somehow make a film which is slightly worse than the last one? DC are amazing at it.
Amazing.
I don't know how they do it.
Absolutely amazing.
Other than Wonder Woman, that's the exception. But guess what? That had nothing to do with DC, I bet. And that was just a Patty Jenkins solo effort.
So Bosco also asked, which is an interesting question.
Yes.
Was there a clear difference between Whedon's and Snyder's direction in the film?
Right. You can definitely pinpoint the moments of levity, if you want to say that. Whedon has that feel. I'm messing up now.
I don't know. I don't think I could have.
No.
I think it was all over the shop.
I think comedy-wise, you know the bit where...
do you think it's Snyder's comedy or Whedon's comedy?
Here you go. I can pinpoint these without even needing to go into a room and look at the edited footage. 100% Whedon is when the Flash draws on the criminal's face. Quickly,
right,
that's 100% Joss
Whedon.
I enjoyed that. And also when Aquaman sits on the lasso.
You think that's Whedon as well?
100%.
Okay, fair.
Alright.
I like it.
So there you go, boss.
Okay.
Hopefully you agree with us in that.
And Bosk ended up, as you always do, with the rule of three.
Yes.
Gal Gadot, isn't she lovely?
Isn't she lovely? If I could soundbite what Aquaman says when he's sitting on the lasso.
I've got a really, really crass thing to say.
Hit me up, John.
But there's one point where they do a Dutch angle.
A revealing
Dutch angle when she's in leather pants. And I'm like, why is this in the film?
Women can be sex symbols, John.
Yes, but in certain aspects...
Is it degrading?
Oh, Christ.
Or should how beautiful women look be champion?
Why am I even talking about this?
And that's getting cut. It's all getting cut. Anyway.
I'm not cutting it, by the way.
Wonder Woman, Bosk. I know where you're getting that.
Smoking.
I'd like to take her to the pub.
Next question, B. Razza is back. At RazzaYoub.
Come on.
Give a follow, people.
Come on.
Did the villain need to be CGI, B? I'm going to say yes, it did need to be CGI.
Ah.
Because they couldn't have done it in any other way. Could they have put a man in that suit?
No, that would have looked so fucking dumb. But here's the point I think he's getting at. Do you put yourself in the position where you choose a character, villain, who it has to be done with CGI, can you not choose someone who is a physical...
Is there anyone in the DC universe that would fight the full Justice League?
Without having to be 12 foot tall.
You could maybe put the Joker in there.
Very good point.
You could maybe put the Joker,
Is
that an intelligence
for
thing?
For me, it's the... I like the idea of the Joker fucking with the league. But
doing it in different ways.
In this universe, it's that much of a CGI mess anyway. I don't blame them. It's just a fucking mess out. Ah, it's such a bad decision. You can't do it. You can't do it and it be good.
I love this next question, B.
Okay.
Team comes together to stop a box from destroying the planet. Am I describing just Justice League or Avengers?
You know, it's funny.
What's funny, babe?
I think that was decided on plot-wise before Whedon joined.
Do you reckon?
Yeah, 100%.
Do you not think Whedon would have rolled with that?
And I think it's what it is a suits have done again. They've done one of them focus groups. Boxes are really a really good symbol of understanding what's some sort of jeopardising item
but
to have.
In the Justice League comics, I don't know much about them, babe.
Right.
Are the boxes massive?
The mother boxes. I don't know much about them either.
Are they like the Infinity Stones?
I think they're just used as...
An excuse to put aliens in the Justice League.
I think they're called boom tubes.
Alright.
They're used as teleporting devices.
Bosk will know this.
I could be completely wrong.
Bosk, hit us up on the Twitter, please. Someone retweeted.
The actual power of the
boxes. Let us know how big the mother boxes are.
Oh, we've got to point out Green Lantern. There's a lantern in the fucking film. Which is really interesting.
Which I enjoyed, but the problem is...
Full CGI, you don't see him properly.
Why don't we get a little Hal Jordan expose like at the end?
That was like 1,000 million years ago.
What?
Can we not just have a nice little moment? More than 5 fucking seconds of a lantern. Yeah.
And he died anyway.
I liked how the right ring, you saw it choose another bearer.
Did that?
That's what it does. It finds the next most appropriate will user.
That's unreal, I like that.
But again, you don't know that because there hasn't been a fucking Landon film.
Beat, next question. Our friends at NTFTT Pod.
Legends.
Our fellow podcast on the Loosely Connected Network. Get on the website, give it a look. We're worldwide. Beat. If Ben Affleck leaves, should they use Flashpoint to reboot the DCEU into the Batman Beyond universe?
Ooh.
What an interesting comment that is.
Wow. So hold on.
So right. Use the Flash to reboot everything?
So one... right. So Batman Beyond is Batman of the future, basically. I want to say Terry...
Pratchett?
No.
I'm joking.
Gilliam, but what? That's someone else. That's not okay. It. Oh, what's he called? Terry Summit. Mm-hmm. Anyway, right. So is...
Terry Crews.
Is... read the question again.
Right, the question is... Ben Affleck leaves, should they use Flashpoint to reboot the DCEU into the Batman Beyond universe?
I 100% agree. What I'd do is reboot the entire
universe. Doesn't Batman Beyond have Nightwing in and not Batman?
No, right, forget what you're talking about. Right. That's the perfect excuse to fully reboot everything without removing characters such as
like
Cavill.
Henry Cavill and
you
stuff
like
that.
You can keep Cavill, but change it into a good franchise.
Right, okay.
So, Flashpoint's really interesting because it's doable. We
so
have
can you quickly explain Flashpoint?
Flashpoint basically is, to spoil maybe some plot points in the future, maybe don't listen.
That doesn't matter.
Flash finds out that his dad didn't kill his mother.
Right.
And he saves his mum by going back in time, because he can run back in time.
Right, okay.
And by doing that, he ceases to become the Flash, and the whole world changed. And this guy called Professor Zoom or something, Dr. Zoom, takes over, and it creates a different universe. Because this is the world where Flash no longer saves people. He's just a normal person.
Does he eventually become Flash?
What happens is Bruce Wayne dies by the gunman.
All right.
He shoots Bruce and Martha turns into the Joker.
Right.
And Thomas Wayne turns into Batman. Jesus. But uses guns. Really cool. Superman turns into a really weak... alien man because he lands in Roswell or something and the government take him and they put him in a bunker and hit him with red solar energy so he never grows and he becomes this thin, awful Superman.
Jesus.
So it takes the characters we know and really transforms them into really cool versions of themselves.
I wouldn't like to see Superman like that.
No, but they all die anyway. Nothing happened anyway. It all gets reset, so don't worry.
Right.
There's not entirety of that plot, okay?
Well, that's that plot. No worries.
I like the idea, though. Really cool. And the segue into Batman Beyond, that's really... I like the idea of both. I don't know if they are actually linked, but the fact that that could be done, I really like. Because Batman Beyond's one of my favourites. A continuation of the animated series in the future. The new Batman they get in, Terry Summit, I can't remember his last name.
Oh, okay.
He's really cool. Really right. Cool version. Opposite of Batman, really, in everywhere. Because laughs. He laughs when he fights people. Rather than he's not the grim and moody guy. He's the jaunty kid who needs to learn
but
hubris.
Would that work on the big screen?
It definitely works in the... If it works once, it'll work again. It must be hard to do, but just try and replicate
before we finish, cheese the questions, people.
Excellent.
Before we finish, let's get Raz's section in.
Let's go.
Segment? I can't speak, honestly.
One or two, don't
I? I need vodka to function.
Fuck the semantics, John.
Right, okay. Who would you have a pint in the pub with out of this fill and beat?
So, I usually go for the femme fatale. I'm going to go Aquaman.
Why? Because he's cool, he drinks whiskey.
Maybe because I might receive abuse if I keep on just saying the woman.
Fair enough.
He seems pretty cool.
Yeah.
He keeps on going, yeah! So every time he probably sang a brewski, he'd probably go, yeah! He's also say, I dig it. Every time I'd
I'm going to go, babe.
Yep.
Gal Gadot. No, actually, I'd go the Flash because
you'd be able to whip through.
You'd be able to get through some pints.
Yeah,
that's
definitely.
All I'm gonna say.
100%.
Right, people, so that brings end to that beautiful podcast of how we loved...
The film. That everyone likes and we've berated by saying it's only for 12-year-olds.
I think there's something going on, I think IMDb set up accounts...
Forge
8 out of 10, 100%. I honestly think it's got to be, because what's going on in the world when this is getting an 8 out of 10 score?
Maybe people have acclimatised to the CGI style.
Maybe we just... like the original Blade Runner. I don't know.
What?
I don't know. Sorry, because I watched that. Yeah, the monologue of Blade Runner is unreal. I watched that the other day.
Right, okay, okay.
That's it. That, I need to watch it again to restart
what
my
what relevance has that got to?
I don't know, but I need to be mentioned.
Okay.
Follow us on Twitter at Talking Crass, people. Check out our SoundCloud, Talking Crass, where we put our stuff on first, so you might get first listens if you're interested.
Oh, baby.
We really appreciate a 5-star review on iTunes. That's what makes us tick over.
Just like this IMDb Justice League.
Exactly. Just like the IMDb ratings, go on to iTunes, leave us a 5-star review, whether you like it or you hate it. It helps us out a lot. Thanks for the support, people.
I've been beat.
And I've been John Momoa.
I like it. Now let's think of a quirky ending. Bye bye. Right, let's hope we don't get copyrighted.
But really,
we need to get the theme of Man of Steel back up because it's just that good. That's all we're ending on. See you later, peeps.
I'm tearing up here.
Tearing up, mate. It's glorious.
It's glorious.
Right, back to the music.
Oh no, he's the Joker!